Welcome back to The Ed Show. The battleground story tonight is just that, the battleground. America has entered its 10th year of war, taking precious American lives and resources with no end in sight in Afghanistan. The death toll continues to rise. More American troops have died this year than at any other year of this war, more than 1,300. And in the process, American tax dollars are being spent on a war with no clear goal or strategy or path to victory. This country has already spent $336 billion on the war in Afghanistan. $336 billion. That translates to $1,000 per citizen in America. Money that could have gone to help the middle class and ease the pain during this economic recovery. It's the old classic, we'll fight them over there so we don't have to fight them here. You buy into that? Joining me now is Robert Greenwald, director of Rethink Afghanistan. And Robert, that is well titled because it is time going into year 10 that we rethink this whole thing. Where are we in a nutshell?
Well, sadly, Ed, we're worse off than we've ever been. The war is a tragedy on every level. It's costing us financially. When I was in Afghanistan, I took a tour of what they call the Beverly Hills of Afghanistan. There were mansions after mansions paid for by our tax dollars, corrupt contractors, members of the Karzai government, and drug dealers that we're essentially supporting with this ill-advised war. And I don't know how many more deaths and how many more billions it's going to take us until we change this policy.
Americans, you want to know where the middle class is? The middle class is over in Afghanistan. We have gutted our infrastructure to make this war a reality for some idea that we've got to do this over there if we're going to be safe as a nation. And Mr. Greenwald, tell us tonight, because, you know, 99.9% of Americans will never get to Afghanistan. When you go over there and see it, is it a game changer for you? Do people that you know come away thinking, what in the hell are we doing?
Well, there's no question about it. I mean, if you go over with your eyes open and you're not on a government-sponsored tour where they select who you're going to talk to, you see right in front of your eyes that it's the third poorest country in the world. They need jobs. They need health care. They need anything but a military occupation. And as my son pointed out to me from the New York Times the other day, $400 of your tax dollars to send 1 gallon of gas to parts of Afghanistan. That doesn't make any sense. And it's not making us safer. It's a civil war. The Taliban have never said that they want to invade or occupy or come after members of the United States. So I don't know what we're doing there.
Well, and politically, it's going to play pretty tough for the president of the United States because something's going to happen here in the next year. This just can't go on the way it is. And is this a case where the base could turn on the president before 2012? What do you think?
Well, already has, Ed. In the year and a half that we've been working on Afghanistan, the polls have shifted radically. We've seen people's opinion change. On our Facebook page, we now have almost 50,000 people who get up every day and work to try to end this war. The base is against them on this. You read the Woodward book, and it breaks your heart how the generals and the military have trapped him into this war, and he's stuck. Hopefully, he's going to stand up the way he did against the Iraq war, speak out loud and clear, and the country will rally behind him.
And Mr. Greenwald, when are you going to be releasing some new footage of what is unfolding in Afghanistan?
Well, I just left the editing room, Ed, and we've got amazing original footage sent to us by members of Afghanistan bloggers who we sent little flip cams to, yep. And it's hard evidence of the corruption around the election. We have videos of people going in with their purple finger, walking out, washing it off, going back in and voting again. We have videos of people checking the ballots and stuffing it, and this is the government that we're asking Americans to die and pay for.
Robert Greenwald, Brave New Films. Great to have you with us tonight. Thanks so much for your work.